The Minister of State for Housing, Persis Namuganza, has snubbed last summons to the Select Committee, which was appointed by Parliament to scrutinise the censure motion.
The Honourable Minister has again failed to show up in the committee. We waited for over 1 hour and a half. There was no communication. We tried to contact our lawyers. The lawyers said they are not aware or they have not been given instructions by the Honourable Minister to come and represent her.
Namuganza, who was expected to defend herself on accusations of misconduct and other ingredients in the censure motion, has skipped committee summons for the third time.
So the committee has decided to proceed ex parte. This means we are going to proceed without her input in this investigation.
The chairperson, Mwine Mpaka, noted that they have decided to proceed ex parte without listening to the minister's side of the story since she has turned down her right to fair hearing.
Her absence doesn't have legal implications. However, she's forfeiting her right to defend herself. But in this particular matter, her absence doesn't have any legal implications.
The seven-member committee has now embarked on a retreat to evaluate the evidence available to establish whether there is a prima facie case against the minister. They expect to have a report finished this week and hand it over to the Speaker of Parliament on Friday this week.
The rules of procedure give us 15 days, and these 15 days elapse this Friday. So by this Friday, we should have handed over this report to the Speaker.
On Friday, the minister delegated her lawyer, Norman Pandey, who was sent away by the committee for lack of clear instructions from her.
Of all places, you appear before Parliament to be an imposter, to represent somebody in the cameras.
The committee has 14 days to determine a prima facie case against Namuganza, which expires on January 23rd. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.